What's up, guys? Brad here, aka Home Theater Gamer, and in today's video, we're going to run Odyssey, and I'm going to show you what I do to get the best results. So maybe you're new to home theater and you've never used Odyssey before, or maybe you've been into home theater for a long time and used Odyssey a few times and never really liked what it did to your sound and just ended up turning it off. In either case, there are a few things you can do to maximize what Odyssey can do for your sound. If that sounds like something you'd be into, hey, maybe hit that like button and consider subscribing. It really helps me out. Now, these things may apply to other room correction software, but this video is only going to cover Odyssey. Now, with that said, before we get started, we need to understand what Odyssey does. And for that, roll the animation. In your typical home theater, you— Whoa. Why are you playing the logo again? I just thought that since I worked so hard on it, that— No, we already showed the logo, they don't need to see it again. But look, just rewind it and start over. Fine. Jerk. In your typical home theater, you have the main listening position, or MLP. Essentially the sweet spot where your system sounds its best. It's smack dab in the center of the room, and it's the place you normally sit when playing a game or watching a movie. Now, as you start to move out of that sweet spot, sound starts to change because the distance between your ears and speakers changes too, causing sound waves to hit your ears either earlier or later. Even moving an inch to the left or right can be the difference between awesome sound and WTF sound. And what do I say to that?
No dice, Chino.
But that's only one piece of the puzzle. Even at the sweet spot, your system might not sound its best because of room acoustics. This pesky little devil is basically sound waves hitting surfaces in your room and either bouncing off of it or being absorbed by it. This can create some funky sounding sounds even at your sweet spot, with certain frequencies even being canceled out completely. We definitely don't want that. Odyssey steps in and tries to correct for both off-axis listening and room acoustics, measuring 8 different positions all centered around the main listening position. It averages those 8 measurements out, looking for similar acoustic problems and issues, and tries to fix them. Its end goal is to create a bubble of great sound instead of a single great sounding seat, while also smoothing out frequency response. But it's definitely not perfect. Issues can arise due to poor speaker placement, measurement mic placement, and typical room issues like vaulted ceilings and open doorways, to name a few. Now, we can correct many of those things to help Odyssey out, such as adding acoustic treatments and covering any windows with sound-absorbing curtains. I won't be covering that in this video, but if you have a room that's especially problematic, it might be worth considering. And just FYI, I will be using a tape measure, SPL meter, and a calibration disc in this video, so if you don't have any of those things, you may want to consider picking them up. So, what can we do to get the best results from Odyssey? Well, first things first, make sure your speakers are set up correctly. Remember, it can't correct for something properly if it's not properly set up in the first place. The subwoofer's position is crucial here too. Don't just throw it in a corner and call it a day. Take some time and figure out where you get the best frequency response in your room by either doing the sub crawl, or for the more advanced users, use something like Room EQ Wizard to figure out where the flattest response is in your room. Doing this step will go a long way and will help Odyssey out a ton. After that, we want to set our subwoofer level using an SPL meter and a calibration disc. Why are we doing this when Odyssey will do it for us? By setting the subwoofer level first before we run Odyssey, we can ignore Odyssey's message to turn the volume up to 50% on the subwoofer, which on some subs is actually way too hot and will result in a trim level of -12 dB after Odyssey is ran. Now, you don't have to level match all the speakers either, just the left front and the subwoofer. So for this, I use Avia. I set my distances in my receiver for the left front and the subwoofer, set the volume to 0 dB, and then I calibrate the left front to 85 decibels and the subwoofer to 82 to 83 decibels, turning the volume knob on the subwoofer instead of the trim level inside of the receiver. With those two things done, we're ready for the fun part, running Odyssey. Now, make sure your room is as quiet as possible, turning off things like ceiling fans and even your air conditioning if you can. Also, close any open doors, and if you have curtains, make sure those are closed too. I'd also recommend ditching that cardboard tripod your receiver likely came with and picking up a cheap mic stand or tripod. You'll have much more flexibility in mic placement and it'll just be easier to work with. To get the absolute best sound possible from Odyssey, we need to place the measurement mic properly. If you play games and watch movies alone most of the time, start with a main listening position and move the mic 3 inches from there for each measurement, and 6 inches for the last two measurements behind you. This will create a tighter bubble of sound, remember that from earlier? Giving you the best sound you can get in your sweet spot. If you often game or watch movies with other people, I'd recommend doing the maximum of 2 feet from the main listening position for each measurement. And again, again, sticking with 6 inches for the last two measurements. This won't get you the absolute best sound from your sweet spot because that bubble of sound will be bigger and Odyssey will have more to do, but you'll still get better sound over a wide area as a result. After you've done all 8 measurements, go ahead and turn your AC back on because it's probably been a while. Verify that Odyssey got everything correct and that your subwoofer trim level is below 0 dB. Selecting reference or flat is more of a personal preference, just know that reference has mid-range compensation and will roll off high frequencies, while flat does neither of those things. Also, leave dynamic volume and dynamic EQ off for now, you can always turn those back on later. Next, make sure your speakers are set to small, your distances are correct, and that your crossover settings are good. Odyssey gets crossover settings wrong most of the time. For my Pioneers, I prefer a crossover of 60Hz for the front 3 channels and 80Hz for everything else, but this depends on brand and preference. 80Hz is always a good starting point though. So this last step is entirely optional, but I've been doing it this way for years and I've never ran into an issue. After I verify everything, I calibrate speaker levels using an SPL meter and a calibration disc. Why? Well, personally, I like to know that my reference volume is 85 decibels when using Avia, or 75 decibels if using another test disc, and I've always also found that Odyssey tends to set the center channel and subwoofer levels 2-3 decibels too low. This fixes both of those things. So set your SPL meter to 80 dB or 70 dB depending on the test disc, make sure you're in C weighting, and run your test to make sure that all your speaker levels are matched. For me, I always set my subwoofer level to 82-83 decibels, which is actually 85 according to Avia. For your height channels, we have no other option but to use the internal test tones in your receiver or pre-pro. Just set these to match the levels of your surround channels and you're good to go. And that's it, you are done. Pop in some of your favorite audio demos and turn it up. And that's gonna do it for this one. I hope you found it useful. Let me know in the comments below if you've tried this method and what your results were. I'd love to hear about it. Also, if you're into home theater and gaming, make sure to subscribe. I post new content every single week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one where I get stabbed in the hand by Peter Jackson dressed as Father Christmas.